And in a place like San Miguel, where the sun is a lot stronger than last year, that's a huge problem. So we'll always be in shape, always, you know, and our children will also have a great place to come to. There's so much light there, and the light is bouncing off of objects and buildings. And even the shade, you're probably going to have so much light on the surface. But for our purposes, I don't want to be able to see them. The nice thing on my knees, although I hate to be a commercial because I'm so old, but watch this. If I'm in the sun, this is why I like this easement, because my French easement will do this. You know, I can tilt this thing to the left or to the right. If suddenly the sun, you know, moves and I didn't expect it, you know, I can tilt this thing a tiny bit and still stand where I am with that pain. So that's a little bit of an advantage to my French easel. Not so much that I learned to buy one, but it's kind of a nice feature, you know. With my French easel, I just simply pick up the entire movement. So yeah, it's not a big deal, but it's kind of a nice feature. Also, this is lighter, and it's so much more packable than my full-box French easel. It takes up a lot less room in my suitcase. I can fold this up because it's super small. It's amazing. Before I do that, though, I'm going to go through the process. These are the only brushes I'm going to take to San Miguel, like six of them. And they're the only ones I need, and I'm going to use them every single day, and I'm never going to wash them with water. And I'll go through all of this the very first day when they're painting. But I have a little clip on my palette, and I fill it with linseed. And my plan is that we're going to buy, you know, a large container of linseed there at the store. We each throw in $3, and we have a big pile of linseed oil, and we all share it all week, right? Anyway, when I'm painting, and you're out there, and you're stressed out because the light is moving, you don't want to waste time having to clean brushes super thoroughly. So what I do is, what I do in class too, you know, I take my brush and I dip it straight up and down in the linseed oil once, and then I get all the paint on it with the red. You know, if I'm being super careful, I'll do it again. I'll repeat that process, but I don't swish it around. I just dip it straight up and down and wipe really good, and I'm good to go. And it works every single time. And those of you who are in my class and see me do demos, you know it works. You know? So I'm meant to only take what you absolutely need. So no solvent when we're out painting, it's only going to be linseed oil. You know, I'm not sure if we can find small containers, and we'll have a small container of it, or if we can find empty bottles, we buy one giant thing of linseed oil, and we all, you know, add it to our occasion. We will figure it out, not a big deal. So that's basically, you know, what I will do. Six brushes. When I'm at home, I keep my brushes on the floor, on a paper towel, right, so the floors will get dirty. And also, one quick thing, I do that on purpose, so that when you're standing up painting, right, and you're standing for hours in this one position and you're really tense, you know, every once in a while when you bend down, you stretch your spine up, right? So you're getting a fresh supply of oxygen to your brain, and you know, it just keeps you a little more alert, it keeps me a lot more alert. So, and also it's more stable, you know, the best thing to remember is you never want to put your I'll demonstrate. Let's pretend this is 14.
The thing you don't want to do is put your brushes on the film.
Because one, they're going to roll around all through the paint and disguise the film. And you're going to pick it up, and now your hand is dirty. And now you touch your eye, it's your eye, and now it's all over your life. And so what you want to do is keep these either in your candy travel port, or on the floor, which is even easier than simple, right? So on the ground, a rag, paper towel on the ground, it doesn't get the ground dirty. So that it works for me. Six brushes, I wouldn't take any more than that. Now even when I'm at home and I'm painting in my studio, I have my Valley No. 5 baseball pen. That's right. Take my glasses off. I find in San Miguel with the light being so strong, I'm probably going to need a bigger hat, but I'm probably going to buy one here because they're used to people needing hats, so they have all of their clients. But the thing about a visor is that it keeps the glare on your eyes, right? So what you want to do is have something, at least this. This is probably the minimal hat I would wear from the painting San Miguel, even in the shade, because the light's so strong, right? If it bounces everywhere, the glare above your eyes is going to prevent you from seeing the value of the color that you need to see. So we'll need a hat. Miguel, and cats are not hard to find in San Miguel. So I'm gonna sweat. We can get paper towels there with all kinds of things. Yes, questions.
Does the color of the hat make a difference? Like I have a blue hat.
It does to me. I'm not sure it does for everybody, but it does to me.
That's why I like this really neutral value number 5 neutral green hat. I had a white one that was so full of paint, it was disgusting. I didn't want to bring it and gross myself. So I brought the clean value number 5 hat. I have a nice, beautiful green straw hat, but something tells me the light coming through that green hat is affecting not only the way I see, but also the color that I'm mixing. So although I love that hat, I know it's warm against me and with me. So any kind of straw hat that's, you know, beige or straw color, perfect, right? But those are easy to come by. So I'm gonna wait till the rest of the day to buy one, you know, because they're, you know, sure they're cheap and plentiful. Anything that I can get away with buying there, I'm gonna do that, because it's not worth lugging people all the way down there. Okay, that leads me to this. The other thing is I only buy like one roll of paper towels, and I have a plastic grocery bag. You know, I'm going to pack some of those in my luggage so I'll have extra. And I attach it to the leg of my easel, and that collects all the bags so that they're not blown away and you have to chase them around. So if you just tie one to your easel, you'll be fine. You can use that bag all day, use it for 2 days, and you're fine. And the other thing is I'm going to bring one or two of these with me, these boards, these white linen boards. You know, it's a little fussy. I like my linen.
But, you know, Philip has assured me in San Miguel there are 2 really good high quality art stores. I'm sure I'll be able to find those in the 2 or 5 minutes, probably will.
You know, we do lots of demos because I'm a very hands-on teacher. So almost every day or every other day, I'm doing a demo, the morning, afternoon, whatever. Lots of individual help and attention. And the other thing about me is if I do a painting that I am not totally in love with at the end of the day, I scrape it off and I use the board again. You know, so I don't anticipate having 67 wet paintings to write home with me. I'm thinking at most I might have 2, possibly if it's a great productive week for me, 3. So I'm not gonna bring a whole extra suitcase for wet paintings on the way home. And also another thing, by the time we're through, most of your paintings will probably be dry anyway, because it's about 3 days before the painting. It's a real humid climate, and it's a little chilly at night, it might take longer. But 3 days on average, it takes a wet paint to dry. If I do have any wet paintings, what I'd like to do is carry, you know, use a bag or a cardboard box as a carrier on the way home. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to have any wet paintings, you know, by the end of the thing. So, you know, think about that. We'll keep them in a dry, warm place at night. I'm not sure what the temperature of that studio is, Phil, you know, that we can use for painting. But I, you know, I started to realize I'm not going to have as many, you know, white paintings to take home as I think. So, and also the other thing about these boards is they're super thin, right? So even if I have 5 of them, they're all dry. It takes up a little bit of my luggage. So in the worst case scenario, I'm going to get a cardboard white painting carrier. Separate these. If they're still wet, like it is, it'll show you how to do it. Very effective and cheap. And they go in a cardboard box and you carry them on the plane on the way home. So they don't damage. So it's not as problematic as I once thought it might be. And that's it. Now I set this up on the way in. I'm going to disassemble it now and show you. It's pretty easy to do. And it's not heavy. So you're not going to need like 2 people. You're not going to need help. If you do need help the first day, certainly Phil's going to be there. I'm going to be there. If you need anything, we're there to help you. But you know, I just got this, so I'm really excited about it myself.
Who manufactures it?
I'm sorry?
Who manufactures it?
A company called Anderson. They're in California. I bought this, however, through Jerry's Artorama, you know, the online giant warehouse site. But they're a family owned company out of California. And I have a feeling if I have to replace parts, you know, I can replace a leg and they'll send it to me, that kind of thing. I think I'll need to. It's pretty sturdy, at least for a couple of years anyway. Oh, by the way, this is on your materials list, by the way. Small tubes of paint.
By small, I mean 37 ml, which is this right here.
I might bring 2 small white tubes instead of 1 big one, because I'm not so worried about them. They're 2 good art stores in San Miguel. If I run my knife, like everything else, in my luggage, you know, which gets checked when it goes under the plane. You know, also we can probably buy these in San Miguel. So I'm gonna bring one and see how it goes and I can buy what I like. But you know, when I'm out painting too, I have a bag, which is a little disturbing. Like a nice heavy canvas bag. I think I might treat myself to one of those art student sleeve bags that we sell downstairs in the store because they're canvas and they're super durable. So I have a big plastic bag of paint, right? And a halite. And that goes into the bag. So let's pretend now that we're out on the streets or we're in El Jardin, we're painting. Time to go home, so we're packing up. So everything, the hat, the paper towels, everything, the paint goes in the bag. And on my palette, let's pretend I have a palette for the white paint now. What I'm gonna do is, now we can probably get these there too. They have grocery stores and stuff, I'm sure. Is I take a plastic container just like this, and I take my knife, which is the bag. And I do this in class too, so I'm better in class for some of these piles of terms. I take all of the piles that I have not used, you know, cat red, cat lemon yellow, all those fairly expensive colors. We don't really want to throw out at the end of the day. And I pick them up with my knife and I put them in the box with the knife, wipe it off with a towel, pick up the next color, put it in, wipe. It takes me about 45 seconds to get all the colors in here. I snap the lid on, the box goes in the bag, and oil paint, unless it's super oily, it's not going anywhere. So even if the container starts to travel up and down, the oil paint stays where it is. This goes in the bag. Disposable white paper palette. Rips off, goes in my trash bin. Right, so now I'm ready to go. Take my palette off. You know, I'm gonna leave my painting. Let's pretend there's a good painting. We're pretending. Painting goes on the ground face up while I'm packing up. Be careful not to step in it. So these things fold in. This is so much like my crashes, it's not funny. Let's go this way. And now that the painting's off, I'm gonna push this thing back. Take this thing off. Just got rid of my trash container, tied it up so it won't go away. Take this thing off. This goes over here. And just like my French easel, these telescoping lenses, they fold right up. So it's really pretty easy. I always like to turn it over nice. So I don't inadvertently hit myself a little bit. Okay, and then these legs fold right up against the side. I feel like I'm a spokesman for the company here.
They don't make it.
I may have a new job after this.
You can still get them.
I'm super careful. But you know, I might end up buying campuses in San Miguel because I'd like to live with them better than this. But look how easy that is, right? It's light, so I don't have to go lugging, you know, endless pounds of things that I need. And the other thing I was going to show you, which is so intriguing, right, is my
new discovery of empty paint tubes. So, you know, I thought, I'm going to go buy all this empty paint in San Miguel.
And that's all I wanted. They're like a gigantic tubes of cat yellow, cat, you know, lemon, yellow, and cat orange. So I thought, why don't I get some empty tubes and just squeeze as much as I need for a week and then crimp them, right? And then mark the outside with what it is.
So I'm going to try them. Now, I don't know how that's going to fly if my baggage gets inspected.
I don't know if you've ever, have you ever had anyone put their and no one's, okay, so there you go.
It's not labeled, they don't even know what it is.
Entrance, right?
Yeah.
You know, worst case scenario, if my paint got lost, I would break down while you paint San Miguel.
I would cry.
I'd try to.
They probably would give it back
to me. Yeah, I'd give it that to her, let's face it.
Yeah.
And if it didn't work, I'd just point it. But I'll tell you about the tubes on these empty tubes. I mean, I like the caps better than my real tubes of paint. They seem more sturdy. So I have not done this before, so this is the first one. But I'm going to give this a try. And I have lots of these, and I only need 20. So if anybody else needs them or wants to try this, let me know, because we can split the cost of this big, huge bucket that I just bought. I don't need them. You know? So there you go. Last thing, very important thing. I never go anywhere, including down, hi. I never go anywhere at all, ever, without my sketchbook. And I forgot to write that on the materials list. So I revised the list, and the one that you have includes all the sketchbook. Because it's so handy, right? You just want to have this thing with you. I'll be doing a lot of demos too, so you don't have a regular notes with me. So a little sketchbook, how tiny is it, right?
But I take this everywhere. I can work all the edges, you know, all the components, you know,
still nice. Well, pastel, you know, it's a little set, 25 set of crepe pots.
We sell them downstairs. They're only $10 for a box, about this big.
Small, lightweight, portable. I would rely on a plane, you know. I think I might break down and buy some colored pencils, because they're a little bit neater than oil pastels, and I could actually draw and do ideas on the plane. Some things out in my head. I always have my drawing pencils and eraser and a sharpener with me. So those are going with me on. This is my carry case. I don't want to be without this ever.
You draw some pieces,
right? Can I do something?
On the other side, you want to
paint. Oh, thank you. Notes. Yesterday's notes. So let's put that in there. My oil pastels would actually fit right in this bag if I brought them. 10 colored pencils, you know, a couple of blues, a couple of yellows, a couple of reds, would fit in this bag, okay? So let's say we're out painting one day, and you have done a painting, you're exhausted, you know you don't have that painting in you. You could do like 5 sketches and get ideas for the next day. So you haven't, you know, wasted an hour on a painting trip. I find this incredibly helpful. So I definitely take it on, and I think, like I said, I might bring colored pencils instead of oil pastels, so I can work on the plane without fear of getting dirty, you know, getting stuff on a CDM airplane. Because oil pastels are kind of messy, so they're great, they're a little bit messy. So that's it. That is it.